Hi, this is A Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about push notifications. Okay, so today I want to talk about push notifications. And yes, I brought back the green screen. I know some of you hate the green screen. Rodrigo, you always say you hate the green screen. Yeah, I'm bringing it back just for today. So today I want to talk about push notifications. Now, push notifications are a way that if you have users who have installed your app and haven't used it in a long time, it's a way to reach out to them. It's also a way for, to send notifications to people whether or not they have your app open or not. In terms of clients, we have a lot of clients that they use it for alarms and stuff to notify their staff of certain things. And it's the kind of thing where we have not used in our own apps, but we've used it for a lot of client apps. So there's something about push notifications that if you're trying to sell an app to a client, they love that idea. They love the push notifications because it pushes it over the edge. They can either reach out to their customers, whether or not they have the app open, or they can use it for an alarm system and stuff like that. So now the way that push notifications work is when you set them up, you basically, like for Apple, you would set up your iPhone app, you have to give it push notification entitlement, and you also have to set up a certificate. And you have to do the same thing with Google Cloud Messenger or GCM network. So you have the GCM or the APNS, Apple Push Notification Service. So let's say you open up your application, and if it's registered with those, it will automatically go to those services and register, and then the user will be asked, do you want, say, EarSpy to be able to send messages, and you say yes or no, and then it gets a token back from them. Now, for a lot of the apps that we've done, at that point, we have to hold on to that notification because that on its own doesn't really help anybody. You need to be able a way to push those messages to them. And a lot of times that means you have your own server. So to let you know the flow of some of the applications that we've done for in the past, it'd be like, they open up the user opens up the application, it gets to either APNS or the GCM networks, and Windows has their own too, but I'd never actually use that. So just so you know. So it goes to those, it gets that token, and it comes back with that token, and then you could take that token and wait until they log in or register. And once they do that, at that point, you can associate that user with that push notification. Or if you don't care who the user is and you just broadcast everything to everybody or based on location or whatever, you could do it before asking their details. So at that point, you can take that token along with the login details and put that to your server. And then at that point, you can have your server send the notifications to the APNS or the GCM, and then that handles sending it to the user. So it's kind of this flow, the way that it goes. Now, and it gets a bit complicated. Now, I've learned this firsthand, especially in the beginning when we started doing this, it's really difficult because you have to think about, are the users, so if you have a cross-platform app, like say it's available to users on Android and on iPhone, you have to think about which phone are they actually using. So we were like in the beginning, just to give you an example, we would take every time the user would log in, we would take that last push notification thing and we would overwrite like a single field in the database. And we had to say if it was Android or iPhone. So for people who had like a tablet and a phone, if they registered with their phone first and then their tablet, the phone would no longer get the push notification. So we have to start associating multiple devices with that user. Now, there's lots of services out there. I mean, there's lots of services out there that take care of it for you. There's Firebase. Firebase does this for you. There's some called like AirPush. Amazon has one called SNS, Simple Notification Service, which they take all that complexity away for you, managing who belongs to what. Microsoft Azure has one called Notification Hub. A lot of these things that we've used, and they seem like a bit of overkill because you don't really need them, and a lot of times they'll charge, but it's usually really low. Like I think the Amazon one charges like 50 cents per million messages, and so it's not that big a deal, and it does make the development process much easier. So it gives you a lot more flexibility, and a lot of times though, if you're dealing with client applications, though, they have to assume that cost going forward, depending on your payment model and stuff like that. So, but it does make it easier. So that way you can have multiple devices. Now there's lots of ways that you can use this. You use it with chat applications. So let's say I'm on the phone and I want to send a chat to my friend who also has the app installed. I could select him, send the push notifications. That would go to the server. The server would see my friend and, you know, based on the, that would look up the friend's token ID, look up that, send the message to the Apple push notifications or the GCM, and that would send it back to his phone. So it really works. And in terms of marketing, I have to admit I haven't actually used it. And I would like to know how, if you guys have used push notifications in terms of marketing, because theoretically I have thought about doing it so we could, we use analytics to track, you know, how often the app is being used, and we could say, for each user who hasn't used the app, who hasn't installed but has not used the app in like the last month, maybe we could send them a push notification just to say something relevant. You know, I don't want to just say, hey, you haven't used it in a while. I'll just say something like, hey, don't forget. You know, you have to tread softly. If you get too many push notifications, you'll get installed, uninstalled. You know, that's the danger of it. And we've all had apps where we've installed it and they just pester us with these push notifications. So that's the dangerous side. And also, yeah, it has to be relevant. So like if I put it in EarSpy, for example, and they open up EarSpy and says, EarSpy would like to send you notifications, I can't see why anybody would allow that. It doesn't fit in with the model of the app. But anyway, push notifications, especially for clients, especially for the way forward, are probably one of the most exciting things about app development. Because, you know, in the past we've done things with SMS notifications, and SMS costs like, depending on the service you go through, it could cost like, you know, three to five cents per notification. So those are the kind of things you want to use sparingly. Like we had one where we wanted to be able to send notifications to the contacts' friends so they could go and download the app, and then we could handle push notifications. That was a situation where we would go through the SMS route. I think we used Twilio, if I'm not mistaken, and then we use Urban Airship for push notifications on that one. But it's a really interesting field. I'd like to know how you guys have used push notifications. Please leave comments. If you use them for marketing, has it helped you? Have you had a situation where you've had push notifications which just did not work out well? And that's it for this week. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.